help come from? My help comes from you, maker of heaven, creator of the earth. I lift my eyes up to the mountains. Where does my help come from? My help comes from you, maker of heaven, creator of the earth. Oh, how I need you, Lord. You are my only hope. You are my only prayer. So I will wait for you to come and rescue me. Come and give me life. I lift my eyes up to the mountains. Where does my help come from? My help comes from you, maker of heaven, creator of the earth. I lift my eyes up to the mountains. Where does my help come from? My help comes from you, maker of heaven, creator of the earth. Oh, how I need you, Lord. You are my only hope. You are my only prayer. So I will wait for you to come and rescue me. Come and give me life. I lift my eyes up to the mountains. Where does my help come from?
Please be seated.
Good morning and welcome. Welcome. It's good to be with you. I'm going to read from James in light of what Pastor John is preaching on. This is James 13 through 18, and it says this. Let no one say when he is tempted, I am being tempted by God. For God cannot be tempted with evil, and he himself tempts no one. But each person is tempted when he is lured and enticed by his own desire. Then desire, when it has conceived, gives birth to sin, and sin, when it is fully grown, brings forth death. Do not be deceived, my beloved brothers. Every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no variation or shadow due to change. Of his own will he brought us forth by the word of his truth, that we should be a kind of first fruits of his creation. We pray for us. Father, we acknowledge that you tempt no one, and that it's on us. We are responsible for our sin, and we confess that before you. We pray for your help, and we love you, your goodness. In Jesus' name, amen. I want to ask you to stand back up, and why don't you walk around and welcome people and greet each other, and we will continue in praise.
Let's all please stand together. We're going to sing Your Grace Is Enough. Great is Your faithfulness, O God. You wrestle with the sinner's restless heart. You lead us by still waters into mercy. And nothing can keep us apart. So remember Your people. Remember Your children. Remember Your promise, O God. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough for me. Great is Your love and justice, God of Jacob. You use the weak to lead the strong. You lead us in the song of Your salvation. And all Your people sing along. So remember Your people. Remember Your children. Remember Your promise, O God. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough for me. Your grace is enough. Heaven reaches out to us. Your grace is enough for me. God, I sing Your grace is enough. I'm covered in Your blood. Your grace is enough for me. For me. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, Your perfect love is casting out fear. And even when I'm caught in the middle of the storms of this life, I won't turn back, I know You are near. And I will fear no evil, for my God is with me. And if my God is with me, well, whom then shall I fear? Whom then shall I fear? Oh no, never let go. Through the calm, through the storm. Oh no, never let go. Every high and every low, oh no, never let go, Lord, never let go of me. And I can see a light that is coming for the heart that holds on, a glorious light beyond all compare. And there will be an end to these troubles, but until that day comes, we'll live to know You here on the earth. And I will fear no evil, for my God is with me. And if my God is with me, well, whom then shall I fear? Well, whom then shall I fear? Oh, no. Never let go through the calm and through the storm. Oh no, You never let go in every high and every low. Oh no, never let go, Lord, never let go of me. And I can see a light that is coming for the heart that holds on. There will be an end to these troubles, but until that day comes, still I will praise you, still I will praise you. We're singing, oh no, you never let go, through the calm and through the storm. Oh no, you never let go, and every high and every low. Oh no, you never let go, Lord, you never let go of me. Will I believe you when you say your hand will guide my every way? Will I receive the one words you say every moment of every day? Well, I will walk by faith, even when I cannot see. Because this broken road prepares your will for me. Help me to rid my endless fears. You've been so faithful for all my years. With one breath you make me new. Your grace covers all I do. Yeah, 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 yeah. Well, I will walk by faith, well, even when I cannot see. Because this broken road prepares your will for me.
Well, I'm broken.
Well, I'm broken, but I still see your face. Well, you've spoken, pouring your words of grace. Well, I will walk by faith, well, even when I cannot see. Because this broken road prepares your will for me. Well, hallelujah, hallelujah, oh, hallelujah,
You may be seated. Let's all sing this together. This is a new song. It's new for us too, so let's try it together.
You are good, you are good, when there's nothing good in me. You are love, on display for all to see. You are light, you are light, when the darkness closes in. You are hope, you have covered all my sin. You are peace, when my fear is crippling. You are true, even in my wandering. You are joy, you're the reason that I sing. You are life, and your death has lost its sting. I'm running to your arms, I'm running to your arms. The riches of your love will always be enough. Nothing compares to your embrace. The light of the world forever reign. You are more, you are more than the words will ever say. You are Lord, you are Lord, all creation will proclaim. You are here, in your presence I'm made whole. You are God, of all else I'm letting go. Will always be enough. Nothing compares to your embrace. The light of the world forever reign. I'm running to your arms, I'm running to your arms. The riches of your love will always be enough. Nothing compares to your embrace. Light of the world forever reign. My heart will sing, no other name. Jesus, Jesus. My heart will sing, no other name. Jesus, Jesus.
Running.
I'm running to your arms, I'm running to your arms. The riches of your love will always be enough. And nothing compares to your embrace. The light of the world forever reign.
Thanks, Dan, for trusting us with a song that you didn't know. That's great. And it's neat, as I'm always encouraged with the things that Dan puts together that are to move us along toward where this whole service is going. Thanks. You know, it's always great to get together and celebrate, isn't it? And we got some things to celebrate today. We've got the newlyweds back from their honeymoon, Dave and Sarah. I'm so thankful that they called and told us that their flight wasn't going to get in until midnight last night, and we were picking them up. So if I fall asleep during my own message, please forgive me. And we're celebrating also a couple of old guys and their birthdays. Roy Long is going to be 90 on Tuesday. And his sidekick, Verdon Mingle, is going to be a mere 83. Just a kid. And then there are other people celebrating other milestones, but those of us who are trying to catch up to these guys, we want to humor them. I just noticed today when I got here that we've got one of our missions couples with Village Missions and the Malottis, and I've asked Robert if he would come on up. Robert and Stephanie are here today in the area for a. You want to bring your wife up with you too? She can come on up here, and we'd like to hear from them as to what's going on over in Tonto Basin, Arizona, in their ministry. And Robert's a pastor over there. And they are a great missions couple who really love the Lord and love his work.
Glad to have you.
Thanks. Well, good morning. We didn't expect to have to give a little speech, but we're
appreciate John's flexibility. I always admire that he's, you know, more flexible than I am. So, you know, when I, as a pastor, you know, I always lead by a tight outline. So thanks, John, for giving us a moment here. Well, as he said, I'm Robert, my wonderful wife, Stephanie. I'm glad that she could come up with me because I'm nothing without her, but she's such an asset in ministry. Well, John mentioned, most of you probably know, but maybe a few of you don't, we're with Village Missions. It's an independent ministry organization that specializes in rural communities all across the United States and Canada. And typically those rural communities, they're small churches. Ours is among that, about 50 people on an average on a Sunday. And typically those churches cannot afford a full-time pastor. And so Village Missions makes an arrangement. We go there as missionaries, so we're two hats, kind of. I'm a pastor and the evangelist in the community, and that's our mission field. And so with Village Missions and as you as a church, and we just appreciate and thank you for your prayers and your giving to our ministry. So they function as a missions organization. So as the church individuals give or churches like yours give, it enables us to be there full time financially. So we don't have to have a second job and be spread thin that way. So again, just thank you so much for your prayers and giving to our ministry. We've been there just over 10 years now. The time goes by so quickly, and it's just been a good ministry. We got there. We had no buildings, and God's led us through a couple building projects. Many of you went through that with us, and we're praying and seeing that happen. And so just our facilities are serving us well, and we're just excited. You know, after getting into a new building, we kind of experienced a year or so of plateau, and we just, that God uses those trials to bring us to our knees and humble us, and so we've really engaged in some more intense prayer and just asking God for renewed energy, new folks, ministry effectiveness, new evangelism ideas, and we're seeing God answer that. And so we just have some new ministries and outreach venues that we haven't tried coming up. And we're just praying and seeing what the Lord will do with that. So it's kind of a more of a retirement community, but there is a school that's kind of a local hub, and there's 80 kids there, kindergarten through eighth grade. A lot of the kids, you know, live like probably here in the big city too, you know, live with grandparents and extended family and such. And so one of the newest ministries we're real excited about, God burdened one of our laypersons very heavily to reach out to the youth. That just, we're losing the kids in this generation. The world is getting them. And so he and his wife, they just entered into retirement, and they're so burdened about it. So they're starting what they call this block party ministry. It's a youth outreach. And so every other Friday, they just have a big gathering. I mean, there's fun and games, of course. Kids are drawn to that. But there's just a focused time of Bible lesson and giving the gospel to those kids as well. And so we just, on the road here, got an email. The last one, we had over 30 kids again at it. So, you know, that's just wonderful. So we're just so excited, and it's mobilizing the church. They see the need for it, and they're excited about it. They're giving to it. And so there's just some neat and exciting things happening. So, I don't know, that's a quick, brief report. I don't know how long. Stephanie, you want Stephanie to share? She has her niche of ministry and areas, too, so I just kind of talked about the things that were on my heart, but let's have her share a couple things.
Well, too. As most of you know, we adopted a baby girl 2 years ago, so she'll be two in March. So I am a full-time mom and wife, and on my spare time, I teach the junior high and high school Sunday school class, and we're studying the Book of Judges right now. And I also play the piano and help lead the worship team, among everything else that a pastor's wife does. So that's where I am.
Well, appreciate your continued prayers for us. We definitely need it. So, all right.
Thanks, Robert. Stephanie, just really great to have you guys here. Thanks for putting us in the stop along the way. Let's pray. Thanks, Father, for this chance to celebrate, and the chance to celebrate birthdays and marriage and ministry. Father, I pray that Dave and Sarah and their marriage, that it would prosper as they keep their eyes fixed on you. And I pray, Lord, that they would purpose every day of their life together to reflect who you are in their personal and personal lives and in their marriage. We thank you, Father, for these people that are celebrating these milestone birthdays, especially Roy at 90. We thank you, Father, for his ministry to so many people in our church, in this community, for his love for the Lord that shows in relationships to all sorts of people, even as he gets out and walks around our community and shares the love of Christ with people as just a way of life. Thanks, Father, for the way he and Verdon and the quartet for years just ministered to thousands upon thousands of people around the state. And we pray, Lord, that you would continue to use these men to honor the Lord Jesus. We thank you, Father, for Robert and Stephanie, for their commitment to your work in a place that's can't always be really very flashy, but thank you, Lord, for their faithfulness and the way they keep at it and faithfully proclaim your word, and for the people in that ministry that have joined them and who are involved in reaching out, like this new couple, even after retirement, they've picked up a new ministry. And we pray, Father, that even as we've heard about these 30 young people that came to this most recent event, we pray that that ministry would prosper. Speak into the lives of these students, and may those students then speak into the lives of their friends about who Jesus is. We thank you, Father, for all sorts of ministries that we can be a part of in prayer and in giving. Father, thanks for the good news from the wards and in Pakistan and in East London, that the work that you're doing. And we pray, Lord, that the work among the Sindhi people in Pakistan and London and dispersed around the world will prosper, and that people, that Sindhi people that give their lives to Christ really so much against living against the grain of their culture, maybe at great risk, we pray that those people that have come to Christ would continue to trust you to use them to reach friends and family with the good news of the gospel of Jesus. We pray, Father, for the Chambers and their ministry through Come to Him. Thanks for the way they touch the lives of people who are in recovery from many, many poor choices, the use of drugs and alcohol, for those who are recovering after time in prison. We pray, Father, that you'd give them wisdom as they ask for that themselves. And I pray that all the finances and the things that they need, leadership that needs to come alongside of them, that these dots would be connected and good things would happen in the lives of people who are living life now at great risk. Thanks, Father, that our church can be a part of this ministry and for the way people from Calvary have so embraced this whole ministry, and that we have people from the Isaiah House that have become part of our lives, and for the impact that makes on us. Thanks, Lord, for the privilege of worshiping you, and we thank you that we can do this. In Jesus' name, amen. We'll ask the ushers to come forward, and we're going to worship by giving. It's another statement of fresh surrender as we give our tithes and our offerings. Let's pray. Father, we bring our tithes and offerings to you now. We're so thankful for all you give us. Thankful, Lord, for your grace. And so we give now, just recognizing your many, many gifts. In Christ's name, amen.
Good morning. My name is Susanna Gruser, and I will be teaching the Children's Church today. We're going to be talking about Jonah and how sometimes we too want to take control back from God for our lives, and we want to take detours in life. And we're going to talk about how God answers that in our own lives. Children, kindergarten through sixth grade, please follow me through the double doors, and we'll go to Children's Church.